Good evening, Boomi community, and welcome back to Dallas, Texas. We're here for our final interview in our fantastic 2 days of live coverage at Boomi World 2025. My name is Savannah Peterson, bringing you all the insights with Paul. Have you had more or less fun than you expected this week?
I had a lot of fun this week. That's, it's awesome. You know, and you know what? Saving the best for last, API management.
I know, right up your alley.
Awesome.
Jaime and Markus, thank you guys so much for being on the show.
Thank you. Thank you.
Jaime, you're not a first-time caller. We did this last year.
We did.
Give us a little bit of an update. So much, it feels like the entire world has changed in the last year.
It has.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, the focus, our focus has been on API management for a few years now, but with the rise of AI and the introduction of new ways to get at enterprise assets, it's become actually more important than ever. So making sure that you have the appropriate governance in place, making sure that you can make those assets available as tools, it really means everything for agentic AI.
Yeah, so you're kind of almost having like an API renaissance moment right now.
Absolutely.
That's got to be kind of fun.
It's one of those APIs are dead, long live APIs.
Yeah.
Yes, there are new ways of interfacing these, but all of the concepts are exactly the same, and so we can bring the expertise that we've delivered in our API management offering to this new AI world.
Yeah.
That's pretty sweet. API management, it's really like the foundational pieces for modernized like AI, LLMs, and interaction with data sources and such. It's really, really exciting times. Because historically, this was like hard-coded connectors, right? And it was like very rigid, very fixed, it didn't work, right? And like now with APIs, you can be fluid and dynamic, especially with AI and LLMs and such. Yep. Where do you think this is going? Where do you think this is moving?
Yeah, I think the thing is AI can only do so much without an API, right? So that's what we're seeing. So the APIs are really fundamental, they're enabling AI. And as such, with all the investments going on in the AI space, there are suddenly also investments in API again, right? So that's exciting times for us as API management, because we now have the opportunity to bring more of what we already did in the past years to a wider audience and also to different personas within our customers.
And so let's dig in there a little bit. I love that you're all having a moment in API land right now. This is like kind of lovely. What are some of the use cases in which you're seeing the most benefit realized or most value created?
I mean, I think in the API world, it's all about tools. Mm-hmm. Your agents, the best agents, the ones that win, are going to be the ones with the best tools. And so if you can expose all of your assets, if you can expose all of the APIs that you have as tools, that's going to make for better outcomes, better business outcomes when you build your agents. The way that we've approached API management, we recognize we're not the only vendor in the business. Most of our customers have 3, 4, or 5 different API management systems. They've got this API sprawl across different cloud environments, on-premise environments. And so by bringing all those things together through API federation, having a catalog of all of your APIs, really getting that full visibility, then you can curate which of those APIs are best used as tools in an AI context.
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, I was just going to say that this is really kind of cool, because I love the fact that you talked about the distributed APIs across the ecosystem, but you have a unified view for managing it. That is something that was a challenge for a lot of organizations, where it was very siloed and the applications would
Absolutely.
Be a one-to-one connection.
Yeah,
right? And
yeah,
those
yeah.
One-to-one connections are just not feasible anymore. It just doesn't work, right?
Yeah.
It's really hard to drive adoption when you've got 4 different platforms to go to. You have a distant... We really unify the provider experience and the consumer experience, and then put a business context around it so you understand the why you might want to use an API, not just the kind of technical aspects of here it is, start coding against it.
Totally.
What is, and I'd love for you to both actually answer this, what's your advice for folks who are trying to navigate this right now as they're building? Because to your point, I mean, I'm thinking of like the shopping cart when the wheels are going different directions and you're trying to push it around. Like when you had all these different silos, you're like really trying to go fast, but you can't really go fast because it's all kind of like awkward. So what are your pro tips? What are your best practices? Markus, I'll start with you.
Yeah, so as Jaime said, like visibility is paramount, right? So in order to do anything with your APIs, you need to know which APIs you have, right? So that's like, first pro tip, know what you have, and then you can start acting on it. Because if you start acting without like really getting a grasp on all your APIs, you just have an incomplete inventory, you have an incomplete experience, people will find some of your APIs, some not, you will secure some of your APIs, some not. So I think like that would be my first pro tip. So
I'd say it's not the one with the most APIs that wins, it's the one with the best APIs. Mm-hmm. So having all those together, being able to curate and deprecate and retire the ones that are costing you money, and then productize and promote the ones that are actually driving value for you is really important. So that governance aspect, making sure there's no vulnerabilities, making sure you don't have performance issues, is between the visibility and the governance, it makes for better outcomes.
What's interesting about where you're going with this is the better outcomes, the tools and such that you're talking about, a lot of organizations are struggling with maturity, right? There's a lot of immature kind of a process and approaches, and it's kind of a little bit concerning to me, right? When we think about the adoption of MCP, right? And we talk about these agent to agents, right? And everyone, there's a mad push to say, hey, we need to move forward, we need to spend money on creating these interactive, interoperabilities between applications and such, and lots of agents are being built, right? So what would you advise the viewers here on they're thinking about ways to do this. This is new to a lot of people. They're trying to figure it out. And there's a lot of buzz. And it's like, how do you know which direction you want to go? What would you advise the audience?
Can I take that?
Yeah, I think there's one thing that you need to understand, right? If you're dealing with humans, you have somebody that talks back. Yes. Right? So you get away with not having a perfect system, because like, if something doesn't work, if people don't understand it how to use, they will just pick up the phone and call you. An agent cannot do that.
Right.
So now you have the challenge to talk to someone or explain something to an entity that can't talk back, that can't ask questions, right? And as such, the tip for customers out there, for people out there, would be like, think out of this view of an agent, right? Would you understand your own APIs if you were not allowed to ask questions? Mm. Right? So that it's just an easy thing, but it just opens your mind for like what you are missing.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. It's kind of a light bulb moment even as you just said that. Like, yeah. Oh, yeah. Huh.
And MCP makes it easy to define these things as tools, but you also need some, it's also immature itself. So this
Correct.
Is an evolving yeah. specification. We need to have kind of an opinionated way to add some of the governance, the security, the enterprise readiness that people need, because a lot of these use cases are on your desktop to a data source that's on your laptop, and that's not what the enterprise is looking. These need to be remote, these
right.
need to be curated, these need to be delivered to the right audiences with the right security in place, the right rate limiting in place, and the right security policies in place.
But there's two factors, though, that kind of play into this. One is businesses are operating at the speed of now, right? They're doing things today, right? And they also have a budget that they have to spend, mm-hmm. right? Because they have allocation of AI for a budget, and they're like, okay, CIOs or C-suites are going, we need to spend this on money. There's the, MCP is not fully baked, fully matured yet, right? But it's a direction that people are going, yep. right? Because a lot of the ecosystem is working in it, working together in it. One of the things I would really like to understand from the API management perspective is kind of the evolution of like an MCP gateway, what is happening on the Boomi platform to make it more fluid and more dynamic. So say, organizations are going to move in the direction of away today, and then they realize in 6 months, that's going to change. How flexible can they be in 6 months from now?
Yeah, I think like, at Boomi, we're doing two things, right? So the first is that we will be offering a bridge that helps people to get their APIs into MCP,
okay.
right, at the moment. And then, as you said, there will be an MCP gateway that allows customers to secure these newly created AI tools. And we build it in a way that we can adapt, right? And so switching protocols will be the job of us as the tool provider, so that our customers can basically leverage a new protocol from day one if there's another protocol that has a breakthrough moment, right? Like A2A right now with agent to agent. So that is something that we want to abstract away in that gateway so that our customers basically don't have to worry about it. They have to worry about the
yeah.
APIs, the implementation. What are they bringing to the table? But not like how the inner workings of the AI stuff will work.
Nobody needs to see the messy bits.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And we've joined the consortium, so we not only have our kind of finger on the pulse of those protocols as they change, but we also have a say. And then as Markus said, we are doing the implementation for you, so you don't need to code those things yourself. And then bringing all of the assets from not just our API management offering, but the rest of the Boomi platform, integration processes as tools, and golden records from Data Hub as tools, and then the agent designer to put those together and really accomplish business outcomes in a really rapid amount of time.
Very good.
How, you've been in this land for a little while.
Yeah.
How much has the rate of innovation and the velocity of what's going on increased?
We've gone through so many technology trends in the last 20 years.
Yeah.
Whether it's mobile, cloud, even DevOps and Agile and different ways, processes ways of developing things. This is unprecedented. It's just a whole different scale. We're talking about MCP. The first version of the spec was published in November.
Right.
A few months ago.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's crazy. My LinkedIn feed is nothing but MCP. But at the moment, it's still a little bit of a science experiment. And so
you
need that kind of enterprise readiness that sits on top. You want to be a first mover. You want to take advantage of AI and this agentic future. But you have to do it in a way that's safe.
Yeah.
Yeah. So how do you keep up? How are you able, Markus? I'm going to turn this one to you since I just went to Jaime on that one. How do you make sure you're doing the right things fast enough to support your customers in the journey with you?
Yeah, I mean, that's a lot of what I do in my daily job, right? Observing the market and being part of this discussion, right? So Jaime said it, we joined the agency consortium, but we're also like having always an open eye on the different specification efforts and what's happening in the MCP discussion forums. So there is a lot of places that you just need to see and watch and to get a feeling. And also like there is really an aspect of community here, right? So that I think that's the other part about that AI movement now. There's a whole feeling of community, and there's a whole, the idea of sharing is basically inbuilt into all of that AI
it
stuff,
is.
And that helps a lot.
Yeah, really is.
It's really refreshing, actually. I'm really glad you brought that up. I mean, I think one of the things I actually love the most about Boomi is your community. Y'all have a really great, the people are all so happy here. Everyone we've had on the news desk is so happy. But I do think it's really compelling, Markus, that you brought that up. Like, the culture of collaboration and openness right now is also unprecedented, too. So it's kind of great, because we're like, well, if we got to move this fast, we might as well do it all together and share insights and figure it out, may the best companies win, so to speak, but it's a very different tone, I feel like, in terms of the culture of collaboration. I've got one final question for you both, since this is a tradition for us now, Jaime, and I'm sure I'll see you next year, and now this will be a tradition for us too, Markus.
Hopefully.
When we are hanging out at Boomi World 2026, what do you hope to be able to say then that you can't yet say today? Jaime, I'll go to you first, because you're right next to me in the hot seat.
I can give you a list of my roadmap. No, it's things are changing so fast. Obviously, 5-year threshold, 3-year threshold. Next year, I think we're going to be delivering some amazing demos where it's, in the next 2 months, we're going to be delivering amazing demos where it's literally every asset that you've built in Boomi over the last 5, 7, 8, 10 years immediately brought to bear in a newly designed agent in 15 minutes or less. So you're immediately delivering business outcomes from everything that you build, building on the investment you've already made. So this is not building from scratch. This is not starting over and learning all these things.
This is optimizing the goods.
This is absolutely taking it and starting fresh from an agent, or taking your existing Boomi integration processes and incorporating agents into those for new kind of non-deterministic and intelligence. It's really exciting, and it's going to be happening so quickly.
Yes, it is. Sure. Well, I look forward to that. We'll keep that 15-minute mark in mind as for next year. What about you, Markus? What do you hope to be able to say?
Yeah, I think I'm largely with Jaime, but I think what will change from this year to next year is we will have the experience of working with these systems, actually, right?
Right.
So from last year to this year, the task was enable it, make it work. And now we have these tools ready, and I'm really excited to see what people will build with it. And that's what we will be celebrating here next year, like have people on stage that don't show tech demos, but show real working examples in production.
Yes, please, louder for the back. Yeah, I know, that is spot on. Well, we look forward to telling those stories with you all. Thank you both so much for being
here with us.
And closing out the show, and thank you, Paul. And a big thank you to our fabulous production team who y'all don't get to see on camera. Bob, Rihanna, Christian, we got Jay in the house, we got Frank Fay with us on the show, and we also had Andrew with us on to open up for our segments here on the show floor. We hope you've all had as much fun as we have had at Boomi World. Also, cheers to the whole Boomi team. I'm just going to give a few shout-outs right here. Greg, you nailed it. You made my manicure perfect by sending me the color palette ahead of time. I'm so impressed. Really grateful for you. But more importantly, y'all make it fun. And we have had a lot of really digestible, great conversations about the front lines of technology all week long. Thank you for tuning in to our coverage of Boomi World 2025 in Dallas, Texas. My name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.